Today we're gonna make Arcoci Arni Juvetsi Stigastra. It is a traditional Greek dish. Juvetsi is a stew with lamb shank. Do it in a terracotta slow cooker on the fire. Come with me in my kitchen. I'll show you how easy it is to do it yourself. Hello everybody, welcome in my kitchen. My name is Nikos and I'm cooking from home for my kitchen and showing you very simple and traditional Greek dishes which mostly you don't find in the most restaurants. So home cooking. So let's start. Show you first the ingredients what we need for our dish for today. Let's go to the hero. Juvetsi, so this is the lamb shank. I always use the best quality I can find. This is from New Zealand, guys. So this is about 1 kilo, 200 grams. I have some rosemary and fresh oregano from my garden. Then we need 800 grams from tomato, chopped tomatoes. As you see, I use the best. It's a bio tomatoes from Italy. I love them. 70 grams tomato puree, salt and pepper, of course. Then for spices, I want 2 cloves. I'll show you in a moment. I have 1 glass of red sweet wine, 2 bay leaves. 1 stick of cinnamon, 1 onion, piece of celery, 2 cloves of garlic, some feta for in the end. I have here some vegetables bouillon made already, 700 grams, and of course our kritharaki, that is orzo, as known in Italian, it's pasta. It has the shape of rice, but it is pasta. Okay, and to make the sauce with it, I prefer a very special Greek wine from North Peloponnese, from the area of Patras. It's Mavrodaphni. I can find it online, but yeah, before I order it, and you know, now with this situation, COVID and blah blah, it takes ages. So I will make my own kind of Mavrodaphni. I'll show you the pot here. So we put 1 glass of sweet red wine. This one I found is from Portugal, kind of like soft port. The barley go in, the cinnamon, and the gloves, 2 of them. So I will warm this up and it will give me the taste a little bit of Mavrodaphni. Okay, to explain you Juvetsi. Juvets also in Turkish. It's a terracotta pot. We call it in Greek gastra. In this case, this is actually an original tagine from Morocco. It makes the same thing. You have also kind of like a Römertopf you can use, or Dutch oven, or just a baking plate what you have at home and put above it aluminum foil so the juices stay inside. On following me, I will start. You will see what I mean. And I will cook this outside. I have a special fireplace outside to cook. Okay. As you can see here, I have my sauce, as I told you, the wine with the herbs. Here I have a grilling pan for the meat. I want to grill it a little bit so it get roasted before I put it in my clay cooking pot. And here I will make my tomato sauce. To start with, the basic of the Greek kitchen is good olive oil. That's why I'm telling you I'm using only the best of the best I can find. And some people don't believe me. Today I will show you. This is olive oil. You saw it won a prize, but except of that, it's from southeast of Crete. I love this. It's one of the best oils, I believe. So use good ingredients. So my wine, you see, it's enough like this. So I turn it off. If you want to, actually guys, in this kind of this thing here, if you put a little bit corn flour, you mix it well, you can impress your girlfriend or your boyfriend like a very chic sauce for the Christmas, you never know. Okay, oily, enough of that. I will put my onions. Onions, you hear this? That's the Greek kitchen. First you hear it, then you smell it, and later you taste it. That's all basic, simple things. Okay, I will put my celery also in a moment. Many people have difficulties with this. Take a grater, vegetable grater, above, and do this. You see this kind of part? These things we take off, we don't need them. Simple as that. That's a nice tip and trick. Because celery is very healthy and it gives a special taste. I don't even practice for that. I not even went to school for that. What about that? Okay, that lovely celery goes in here. Okay, that is done. We wait a little bit. The onions. My grill pan is hot. I have some fresh oregano and rosemary. I will put some salt, thick salt, so it doesn't get, so the meat will rest on the salt. So I put my meat. Exactly. That's again the sound we want. Manamu. So this can go away. Hoppa. See, we turn our meat from outside. It has to get nice roasted. This lamb, actually, guys, the best of the best from New Zealand. Yes, you pay a little bit more, but it's worth it. Okay, what I do now, I put my tomato puree in the sauce. We don't need to put salt here because we have later our vegetable brew. There's salt in it. Mix it a little bit so the sour taste of the tomato puree, if you cook it like this, you fry it, it goes away and it's very tasty. A small trick to get the sharp, sour taste of it away. It's a simple way. Just put a little bit of honey. Voila. Or sugar. I prefer honey. Honey is more healthy and gives, for me, a better taste. Okay. This is almost done. Oh, you could smell it, guys. It's like heaven. I'm looking for stuff. Anyway, I have to turn my meat. Oh. In the future, they will have maybe cameras that can have also the sense of smelling. But from now, I'm telling you, this is heaven. Okay. Now we put our special wine. Exactly. I drained. You remember I put spices in the wine, I drained it. Put it in, leave it a few seconds to boil the alcohol up. Do not sense anything from the alcohol. And now we put our chopped tomatoes. Exactly. It's 800 grams. Okay, some little bit from the stew because in the can always stays a little bit the rest. I find it a pity. Like this, you will have everything out. Okay, my lamb is perfect. I will stop it. It's enough like that.
So it's from outside, nice roasted. The sauce a little bit more. 2 minutes. And any moment we're gonna mix all that goodness in our gastra, in our clay cooking pot. Sauce is also ready. Put some paper. All right. So my meat is also ready. What I'm gonna do now is put the meat in here. Voila. Kind of in the center. Try to fix it like that. It stays. Okay, the rosemary, why not? Let's take it with us, put it in it. Okay, and now we put our sauce. Be careful when you do that. It's everything hot, safety first. You can do it, you can pull the whole sauce in it. If you find it too dangerous with some big label, something like this, you get the point, you just put it slowly. Anyway, I did it that way, and now we're going there in a moment to our fireplace to continue this lovely dish. Everything is here ready, it's exactly where I wanted. This will do is magic. Put the lid. Okay, if you don't have this kind of construction or Römertopf, as I said, Dutch oven, whatever, you have something, I don't know, maybe a baking plate, something like that. So, or terracotta, whatever, you see the point, and put alum foil baking paper or alum foil above it, and then put it in the oven. This thing like 170 degrees Celsius. Prepare before the oven is on temperature, 170 degrees for 1.5 hours. Will do the same job as what I'm gonna show you any moment. Simple. Okay, so we are outside, so I have this lovely thing. It's a mixture of terracotta and stone. It's very special, it's made in Crete. I have here my charcoal. That's simple. We don't even need fire. It's very hot. We put it away. So that's my charcoal.
Yeah?
Okay, so let's go outside. You saw we are ready to cook a lovely stew. Okay. Here we are. So, this, guys, I'm calling traditional cooking. And to inform you, I'm busy with my son to start a small company here home. I call it dark kitchen at the moment, so I call it more home cooking. And I don't know which kind of form we do it through internet and sell our meals, original authentic Greek meals, and that's an example of it. More to come. Okay, enough with blah blah. This will live for I will leave it for 2 hours. And after 1.5 hours, I come and check how it goes. And the last half hour, we will put the rest of the ingredients. I will show you later. I have it at 2 hours. You saw on the fire outside. And look at this. It is melting. So on the top, you don't need any more. What I will do now is take out the meat. Oh, lovely. Because I have to mix the sauce with our orzo. Show you in a moment. So that's a step one. You see the meat almost falls apart. So what we're gonna do now is in a pan. Here the heat, I put some butter, something like, I don't know, 30 grams. Because we still need to prepare our torso, our orzo. It's Italian actually, kritharaki in Greek. And you can see also from this magical sauce, I will keep some apart. There is a reason for it. You will see in the end when we actually will serve it. So this is enough. This I keep to the side. Perfect. And now my butter is fine. We put our 500 gram kritaraki, orso in Italian, because most people know it as orso. Some little bit salt, pepper, and a little bit of mint, just to give it. And then we're gonna brown it 2-3 minutes, so all the flavor will go later nice in it, the sauce and the meat. The oven I have already preheated at 200 degrees. I have the above as a grill and from under the air. So above and under, it depends your oven, around 200 degrees Celsius. The oven is ready. On top of the oven I have the grill function. Maybe you have it too. Depends on your oven. If you have it, use it. So the orso start smelling. The sauce is like killing my nose. So you see, simple ingredients, but top quality. That's very necessary. And the hero is not the orzo or the meat or fish, what you put, vegetable or whatever. In the Greek kitchen, the hero is the olive oil. I cannot telling you this enough, and you have to really get into your olive oil. It's very, very, very important. Get the best quality you can find. And in these days online, you can find anything and everything. Okay, now we roast it. You remember from the beginning I had this vegetable stock, bouillon, from vegetables, 700 ml. I'll put this inside. And behind the camera now it's my lovely wife, and she smells nice, isn't it?
Mm.
Okay, now the mint did his work. We don't want it to keep it in there for very, very long. So all this goodness. Okay, now if you're afraid, this has to go in the sauce and then the meat. If you're afraid to do it in the way I will do it right now, I said it earlier, just do it step by step like that. Slowly, slowly, it's also okay. But I will do it differently. I will put the whole pan, and actually this has to go off my fire. Okay. I don't need the top at this point with the pan. Mix a little bit in the sauce. Exactly. That is nice, telling you. Okay. And in here, of course, we put back our meat. Try to put the meat in the sauce as much as possible. And the bone can be this for your loved ones, they will love you even more. Okay, this whole thing, the oven is ready. 200 degrees for a half hour. Check it after 20 minutes. It depends your oven, it depends the orso, it depends many things. So around 30 minutes. And I will see you at the end result. 30 minutes is passed. In the end stadium, we have our lovely Juvezzi. And
Look at this, guys. That's lovely. So, I will take one piece. You see the meat almost melting. Look at that. Like this. Let's try the orso. Oh my God. Let's try to make a nice dish. You saw it's a bit work, but we get rewarded. And one, two, three. Like this, you can, make it for your loved ones. Here's the meat. Some mint we put. The final touch is to take some feta, just above everything, some feta, okay, the feta, and then we need the olive oil, of course, in my hand, then we take very virgin olive oil, just a few drops on the meat and on our orso. And on the plate. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is my Juvetsi. Our eastern neighbors, the Turks, call it Juvets. Okay, thank you. The rest, you know, all the likes and subscribed and blah blah. Thank you very much. And the next Friday, and it's Christmas, and to honor our friends, the vegetarians and the vegans, I will use this. It's a plastic. I will show you from the scratch how we make our own phyllo dough to make a spinach pie, spanakopita in Greek. Next Friday, no big meat, no big fish, nice spinach pie made from the scratch. Love you all, ciao.